Welcome to SNIS Mobile Studio with Science Comm 2019.
Thank you.
We are here with the Professor Andy Miah, or Miah?
Miah is correct.
Yes. Miah. Welcome.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be here.
So you were the keynote speaker this morning at the Science Comm. Can you tell us if this is your first time and what are the impressions after this day spent here?
It is my first time at the conference and it's been wonderful. Everyone's very excited and enthusiastic, but also has very different approaches to science communication. So the thing I've enjoyed most is hearing different people's ways of thinking about communication, which are across film, across video, virtual reality, all sorts of platforms and different ways of approaching it, which is great.
And can you tell us a little bit about your background and how you came to do communication about science and how your professorship at the University of Salford fits in with the broader scope of Salford's mission?
Absolutely. So my entry into science communication was as a PhD researcher when I was told by a professor that the average academic article is read by six people. And so I felt we had to do more to share our insights, share our research, and so started building websites. And out of that came a long journey into communicating science through lots of creative media channels. And at the University of Salford, that's become part of a big program of work now where we're trying to encourage staff to be more creative, be more innovative, and think about their role in society at large. Because for me, at the heart of science communication is not about trying to inform, educate, or even engage. It's about making sure that science is at the heart of democratic societies. It's not that we should do it, it's that we really need to do it because that's part of being a citizen. And so a lot of the time, I think many people still give a lot of emotional labor to their science communication activity, but that's changing slowly. It's being recognized more as part of our job, part of something that we need to get funding to do, and hopefully we can be more ambitious with this extra support.
Your message with the keynote speech was that communication about science needs to be introduced really early in the training of a university student. Is this just a message or is it also a project that you're developing?
Well, I think that if we look at what's happening in the world today where young people of school age are protesting in the name of the environment, we see how they're engaged with science, engaged with scientific methods as a way of figuring out what's happening with our world and doing something about it. So I think that science communication should begin as soon as possible. And that doesn't mean when you enter university or when you've got a PhD. It's actually the moment that you begin to encounter scientific knowledge is the moment when you can begin to communicate it. And there are wonderful examples of many young YouTubers that are out there sharing scientific insights, giving their own critical interpretations of what's going on, and that's where we need to start. In fact, accessing and engaging young people before the age of 10 is where we need to focus our attentions.
And have you encountered or do you know of any obstacles that exist in this on the way of this mission?
Well, there are lots of obstacles, especially when we're talking about young people. You know, if you want a Twitter account or any kind of social media account, you have to be 13 years old, which is, in my mind, too late. So we need to really think about how we empower young people to be publicly present, but also be mindful of the risks associated with that. At the same time, many people in science still think of science communication as a scientist sharing their results with the public. But it's much more complex than that. It's scientists sharing their work with each other. It's trying to identify different types of communities of people, but also finding new spaces of dialogue and conversation. I think much of what happens in today's mainstream media is broken. And in fact, social media is not much better. So we need to take ownership of the channels of communication and make them different.
So in spreading this message, what have been your main takeaways, the main insights for you?
Well, for me, the biggest insight is how much people get out of doing science communication. It's not just a practical task that people feel they need to do. It's in fact incredibly rewarding for scientists to be out there in the public. I've got colleagues at Salford University, genetic scientists that will take out DNA reading machines to festivals, and in the pouring rain will swab people's DNA, tell them a bit about what's happening inside their body, and they love it. They love the atmosphere, they love the contact with the people, And I think that's the most rewarding part of it, is realizing that actually your work has value beyond your professional network.
Speaking of the value of work, what about measuring impact of such communication?
Well, I think a lot of people measure impact badly. And what we've tried to do at the University of Salford is partner with organizations that have done this for many years. So, for example, in the UK, the arts sector has been heavily under pressure to demonstrate the impact of their work. So they've developed quite sophisticated ways of evaluating audience impact, public value, and we've tried to work very closely with them in developing our own measures of impact and value from our audiences and participants.
And finally, in the universe of science communication, what would you like to see more of and less of also?
Well, my biased perspective leads me to want to have more immersive experiences in science communication. So we've been experimenting at the University of Salford with virtual reality, with mixed reality experiences, where people can use augmented technologies to help them convey more about the physical world in which we live. And I think partly we do that because we can see that's coming down the road, that there's much more of this kind of interactive physical contact with digital experiences that's going to transform how we live in the world. So I'd like to see more of that, more innovation. I'd like to see less lectures and discussions, because actually there are many of those things that take place. And what people really need is to be hands-on participants in science communication, not just audiences.
And Miah, thank you very much for being here, and good luck with the rest of the day.
Thank you very much. Pleasure.